Hello, my loves. Welcome back to Bahati Life YouTube channel. I'm Jessica Alexandria from Bahati Life Apothecary and the Sacred Circle Tarot School. Thank you so much for tuning in and welcome back if you're part of my beautiful Bahati Vibe tribe. I got a notification in my comments. So someone sent me a DM not too long ago and she said, "Girl, what is going on? I've been crying since yesterday. I've been in bed all morning. I'm like, what the fuck is going on?" Pardon my French. I'm glad you asked because there are a few things that we need to talk about this week. Major things that just all happen to be compacted in one small chunk of time that is going to be a life-changing experience. It's gotta be. It can't not be. The first one is Saturn retrograde just happened. Mercury retrograde is about to happen, and then we have a total lunar eclipse all happening within like 7 days time, 7 to 8 days time. So yeah, that is a lot. Each one of those are a lot individually, but when you put all of them together, it is a 1-2-3 punch. You guys know that I don't believe that retrogrades or the planets moving in adjustment or eclipses are negative or bad or evil in any way, shape, or form. In fact, one of the biggest mottos of Bahati Life and myself is that if you know how to work with the planets, you can make them work for you and not against you. And one of the best ways to give you guys this information and to guide you through these turbulent times is by informing you and giving you a backdrop of what these planets are like, what they're trying to do, and what you can do in order to work best with them. Now, I've been getting a few minor complaints lately of people just saying that I talk too much in my videos. And the thing is that I don't want to microwave information that is powerful. I don't want to microwave and give you a shortcut in information that can really change your life for the better. Having said that, I will take that positive feedback or that constructive feedback, and I will maybe not dive into each of what those planets, like in depth of what those planets are. You guys know I'm Virgo all over my chart, so I'm very, very thorough, especially when it comes to how I'm of service to my clients, to my community, to my people. And I wanna make sure that you guys are good, that you're solid. So I will kind of meet you in the middle ground and we'll see what happens with that. But okay, let's go ahead and dive into this week. First and foremost, how are you guys feeling after this weekend? Point blank period. Let's just start with that. And when you do, let me know down in the comments, even if it's just an emoji or a smiley face or an unsmiley face, please make sure that you do include your rising signs, because I am still always and forever doing astrological research, and the rising sign is everything for me as an astrologer. Saturn retrograde. The time of me filming this, it's the 24th. Saturn went retrograde yesterday, the 23rd. Now, for those of you guys that don't know, and I'm gonna give you a little clip, a little blip, Saturn is all about commitments, restrictions, boundaries, rules, regulations. And when Saturn goes retrograde, now in the sign of Aquarius, this is when we have to really start questioning, okay, as I am building this new life for myself, as I have taken all of these lessons, especially within the last year and a half, year and some change, and I'm trying to rebuild who I am and my foundation and what makes me safe and stable, you're probably thinking, Jess, 2020 and 2021 have already disrupted so much of my life, and now I kind of have to revisit those issues. I have to revisit these problems or revisit these ideas. And yeah, honestly, you kind of do. And it's not to slow you down. In fact, it's there to strengthen you up big, big, big time. What you have already learned, especially in 2021, with Saturn now moving to the sign of Aquarius, it wants to kind of disrupt and revolutionize the ways that you have set yourself in, or the ways that the world has already set itself in. And yes, this is going to be our new normal. And yes, these are things that are going to be a heightened priority to us, but we don't want to just automatically cement ourselves into this and say that this is the only way that it could be. Why? Well, because Aquarius is where Saturn is currently transiting, aka moving through, Aquarius loves to revolutionize things. Aquarius loves to breathe new life and keep it fresh and funky and weird, right? In a way that it works for you, because Aquarius heightens the sense of being an individual, of being eccentric, and also using those eccentric details that make you so unique, and then helping the world on such a larger scale. Not only are these aspects within yourself, for example, this new idea of our society, you know, working from home, and these different businesses and organizations are all kind of working from these different hubs and little portals where people are individually, independently working all by themselves, all for themselves. So, and that was, if you guys are been a part of the Bahati Vibe tribe for a minute, you knew that I predicted this before coronavirus. I kept saying these little pods, these little portals that everyone is going to be working from, and that's exactly what we've all been doing. Now that things are becoming more normal, and I'm putting that in air quotes, now that things are becoming more normal, now that Saturn is trying to root itself and set these things into place as it's moving to the sign of Aquarius, this new normal, now that it's retrograde, it's like, okay, yes, this is our new normal. Yes, this is what you've kind of gotten adjusted to and acclimated to, although it's still pretty fresh. But now that it's retrograde, we want to make sure that our routine, our structure, our rituals are still serving us and are serving us. And if not, I'm going to work, Saturn saying this, I'm going to work to break this down. Now, there are aspects within Saturn energy that's very dry, very stoic, and very emotionally detached. So you will also find this same energy in people or within yourself. So this could mean that within your relationships, you might find that you are dealing with someone who all of a sudden is feeling very cold, emotionally detached, or emotionally reserved, or you're feeling the same thing within yourself. Why? Because your attention or their attention is being drawn to be in different aspects outside of the intimate connection of the relationship, or the intimate connection of the relationship with the self. Right? So this can be really tough to deal with, and this can bring up a lot of wounded issues from the past. Just naturally, it's there to strengthen you, to stabilize you, and to make you a cool, calm, collected leader. At the same time, you guys, especially with Mercury retrograde, we're going to start seeing some communication blips. We're going to start seeing some changes in the mind, what you're thinking, what you want, where you're going, the path. And these are things that you, I just heard the word, are, it's going like forbidden. It's going to feel forbidden. It's going to feel like something that was taboo. But it's really, honestly, the spiritual world, so your ascended masters, your ancestors, your spirit guides, your angelic team, speaking to you and working with the planets in order to give you direction into things that you normally would not have considered. That's why I feel like it feels like it's taboo. Now, don't forget, for 1 second, the fact that Chiron is also still moving through the sign of Aries. And this is going to take some time for us, and we need to take some time for us. Chiron rules and represents the aspects within ourselves that need to be wounded, that need to be healed, and that need to be addressed. And with this, we're going to feel this rubbing when it comes to how we identify, how we feel confident, and how we are pioneers for ourselves, for our careers, for our children, for our business, our brands, all of that. Just the fact that Chiron is sitting in the sign of Aries, again, it's I am. So we are redefining ourselves as a people. We are redefining ourselves as individuals. We are redefining ourselves as business owners, as parents, as sisters, brothers, family, friends, whatever the case is. And within that, all of this is being pushed and pulled into your idea, your perspective of yourself, Sun and sitting in the sign of Gemini, but also it wants to heal the aspects of how you identify yourself by being triggered by this new normal, this new way of life, this spiritual purpose that is getting pulled from such a higher place. That's Jupiter in Pisces, tune in Pisces, then how we move, making sure that we are emotionally and spiritually and mentally nurturing and nourishing ourselves. That's Mars in Cancer. And then all of this is getting triggered by the eclipse. This eclipse is going to be a total lunar eclipse, you guys. Shout out and RIP to who I once was, right? That's going to be all of us. RIP to who I once was. RIP to who we once were. RIP to what this once was. The total lunar eclipse, and I made a whole video about this and I'll link it down below, but the total lunar eclipse just completely blasts in your face all the things that you may not feel so comfortable seeing, you may not have seen, you may not have addressed. It's things that need to be dealt with here, present, now. And in the sign of Sagittarius, which is where this eclipse is gonna be happening, this is going to hyper-focus on our beliefs of ourselves, of our world, of our relationships. Whatever it is that Sagittarius, whatever house Sagittarius rules within your chart is exactly where these beliefs are gonna get hyper-focused. Now, not only is this going to be Sagittarius energy, but it's also going to be impacting the energy of Gemini. What does Gemini rule within your chart? And I can't help but also look at the fact that Mercury is going to be retrograde. Again, that's the 29th. Moving backwards through the sign of Gemini. So these are conversations, thoughts, ideas that we cannot neglect and that we cannot leave behind. I know that Mercury retrograde gets such a bad reputation, but with transits like this, you guys, this is really such an opportunity to pick up what we've dropped behind us, to pick up what we've left behind us. And I understand that in a lot of societies, everyone is so hyper-focused on moving forward, of not looking back, of cancel culture, and it can be very unforgiving, and it can also be relentless. Relentlessly unforgiving and unloving and very cold, detached, and informal. And honestly, the planets and spirit does not want and see that for us. It never did. It's the planets right now, especially with Neptune and Jupiter moving through the sign of Pisces, it is trying so hard to teach us with these slow lessons of being forgiving, of being compassionate, of being kind, and taking all people into consideration because all of us are equal. And this requires such a higher level of sacrifice, of self-sacrifice. Why? Because it's no longer about our individual needs. It's about all of our needs. It's about checking in. And I understand and I've seen how, you know, there's this idea of independence. I don't need anyone. I'm about that bag. I'm about this, you know. And then also bringing in the aspects of psychology and canceling people because they themselves are healing, or they themselves are learning and growing, or they're not growing fast enough, or they're not meeting expectations. And so people are so quick to call them toxic when at the end of the day, to be honest with you guys, they're human. And I'm not giving anyone permission to be toxic, to be an abuser, to be a manipulator, or anything else like that. But I am saying that as high vibrational beings, there does have to be a very forgiving space and grace given to those who are trying to do better, but they need some time, they need some softness, they need some kindness and compassion. And I want to challenge you guys to be the first ones to give that to yourself, but also to give that to the people of the world, right? And I will say that Saturn retrograde, Pluto retrograde, Mercury retrograde, and the eclipse, there are going to be so many lessons that spirit is welcome to give to you right now, but it's going to ultimately be up to you to decide and to choose if you are going to sit with this lesson and learn from it and become your greatest and best version of yourself. There are aspects within your life that are frustrating you, that are disappointing you, that are breaking your heart, that feel like they are just ravaging you. And what I don't want you to do is to turn your back away from them and pretend like they don't exist, or to cancel them completely out. This is always an opportunity for you to see things from a different perspective, for you to completely transform your world and who you are and your relationships and your career and your purpose simply by observing them and striving to understand them. Such a beautiful message that I have here for you guys. I did pull some cards from the Wisdom of the Avalon Oracle deck by Colette Barrett Reed. We have Disruption, we have Deception, the Owl, we have Burden, we have Lady of the Lake, and the Raven. And the thing is with these cards, my loves, is that I can see big, big, big time the burden that Saturn and Pluto give, the baggage that is that they give. The thing is that it's not that these planets are giving baggage, they're revealing baggage that you have been given by the world, your circumstances, generational curses, etc., etc. And it is a deception. It is deceiving to you, and you're deceiving yourself by believing that you are a victim in any of this. Okay, so we all have lessons that we have to learn. Every single one of us, myself included, all of us. We all have baggages that we have to learn. We all have things that we have to learn how to carry or understand why we were carrying them to begin with. And the way to look at that, especially with Pluto, Saturn, Mercury retrograde, is by revisiting the past. Picking up what we've left behind is a necessity. It's necessary for us to carry forward and to be healed and to be powerful and to be uplifted, okay? With that, that's where this disruption is coming from, because the planets themselves will not allow you to move forward and not see, address, heal, handle things that may be uncomfortable, things that you felt like you may have already, you know, things that have already transpired, things that you just want to kind of like, okay, I've already cut that person out, I've already cut that out. But number one, there's a reason why it was there. And number two, there's a lesson to be learned from it. Number three, there's a lot of growth that can come. And number four, there's a whole future ahead of you that you're going to experience, but you want to make sure that you're not repeating past patterns, or you're not neglecting or avoiding aspects within yourself that came from the lessons of the past, right? So with the Raven card and also with Lady of the Lake, this is about seeing things for exactly what it is that they are. Nothing is a coincidence. Everything is absolutely synchronistic, and that's where the real magic lies. Okay, so there's an opportunity, like it is that I was saying, to really step into your power, to step into your magic by seeing things for what they are, and you have to be courageous and bold in doing that. The next few cards that have jumped out are from the Crystal Spirits Oracle, also by Colette Baron-Reed. She's killing the game when it comes to oracle cards. And this is the Emerald, this is Petrified Wood, this is Orange Sapphire and Rhodonite. The thing is with these crystals is that they want to connect you to the heart. They want to connect you to the tangible. They want you to slow down and see the value in what has already happened and to apply those lessons now, to revisit those lessons, to welcome them in, not in a way that you don't have boundaries, because again, Jupiter and Neptune in the sign of Pisces is big time asking you to have healthy boundaries. That means that you take it in stride, you take it step by step in what it is that you're accepting, what is that you're learning, and you're not just canceling it out and being like, doesn't exist, you don't exist, it's done, blocked. It's really easy to do that, but all of that is an illusion, it's a fantasy. You're just blocking people on social media, when in reality, you're not dealing with it, and ultimately, spiritually, energetically, you're blocking your heart, you're blocking your blessings. Real rep, bro. We're gonna talk about it. Can we talk about it? We're gonna talk about it. Next few cards that is that we have here, we have new idea, time to decide, your wishes are coming true, wise soul, and you are a spiritual teacher. Now, when I'm seeing these cards, what it is that I'm seeing is the fact that the planets are teaching you that they are the spiritual teachers, right? Or they provide the lessons to you as a spiritual student and a spiritual teacher. Why? Because in everything that is that you're doing, you have a lesson there to be learned. And as a wise, intuitive soul, you're going to understand things in a way that is just so unique to you. Again, that's something I've been talking about a lot on my YouTube channel. Now, when it comes to new idea, this to me gives me a reminder to give to you guys perspective shift. Total revolutionize the way that you're thinking, and also your day-to-day life, how you're taking care of yourself. I mean, the list goes on and on. When it comes to your wishes are coming true, some of you guys need to hear that, because you feel like in order for your wish to come true, you have to move forward. Sometimes you have to, again, decide to revisit the issues, conversations, conflict, things of the past, or at least deal with them, organize them, get them right, get them solid, so that you have a good, strong foundation. Pluto and Saturn retrograde. They want you to be strong, they want you to be powerful, they want you to be impactful, and they want you to be solidified. Next few cards, we have the Goose, we have the Peacock, the Cheetah, and the Dog. So with the Dog, it's so interesting because it focuses on loyalty and faithfulness. There are some aspects within your life that just simply will not leave you, or some people in your life that will not leave. If that truly is the case, we want to make sure that the boundaries and the relationship itself is healthy. We don't want to judge it. We don't want to judge and be harsh towards the aspects within ourselves that are loyal to us. We want to make sure that it is healthy and healing. right? The goose brings the energy of taking time to rest and recuperate rather than continuing your striving. Striving means that you are forcing the outcome, you're forcing your movement, you're not stopping. And that will be exhausting. That will be energetically exhausting and not what it is that you want to do. The peacock, let yourself stand out and be noticed. Big, big, big time. Something about this is turning me to Pisces energy again. Jupiter and Neptune in the sign of Pisces and big time Aries. Chiron sitting in the sign of Aries. This is about how you are creative, how you are a creative healer, how you are a powerful intuitive, how you are divinely inspired, how you are divinely connected. So this is why it's like, okay, let yourself be stand out and notice. Let you see your light and let others see your light as well. And with the cheetah card, the final card, get clear on your intention, stay focused, and move quickly to achieve your goal. With the word quickly, I kind of want to put that on a little blip, like a little pin in that, because I don't know if it's necessarily possible to work quickly with Mercury retrograde, Saturn retrograde, Pluto retrograde. I see this with quick, I see masculine energy. And I saw a comment on my YouTube channel this morning of someone being like, Jess, you're mentioning masculinity and toxic masculinity, but my issue is coming from women. And the thing is that masculine energy is not defined to a gender at all by any means. It really isn't. Masculine or feminine energy is going to be found in each person regardless of how you identify, regardless of how you were born onto this earth. It's just a matter of how that energy expresses itself, and each one of us has to learn how to work with both of those energies healthy, okay? When I'm talking about masculine energy, it's very dominant, it's assertive, it says this is what it is and now I'm going to move towards it. That's what I'm getting when I'm seeing the cheetah here and move quickly to achieve your goal. I feel like this is to move assertive, move in a way that you know that what you want is what you're working towards and that's where you're going and that's where we're headed. That's what it is that I see when it's moving quickly. And I feel like for the time of Pluto, Saturn, and Mercury retrograde, I want to see you guys set intention for this retrograde cycle and also set intention for what you want to grow and learn from. So there are aspects within your life that you probably, looking at the chart, there will be aspects of your life that you might be struggling with. It could be anything. It could be aspects within yourself that are just really struggling to heal. So this would be a great time for you to revisit resources, communities, support, therapy, friendship circles that will help you to heal those aspects during this retrograde cycle. That's a great way to work with the Pluto, Saturn, Mercury retrograde cycle. Or let's say there's aspects within your career that are stagnant. Well, during this time, during these cycles, you then set intention, okay, I'm gonna learn the most from this area within my life. And if you need to get hints and tips on where and what area of your life you would be probably hyper-focusing on on your healing, go ahead and pull up your natal chart. I use astro.com and put in their transits so you can see where these planets are currently transiting. Make a mark of that, and then overnight, go to your altar, set intention, talk to your ancestors, your guides, and ask them, okay, inspire me, or I want to hear from you the ways that you see I could be better in this area of my life, and then sleep on it. Document all the things that is that you're dreaming about, journal it all out, and then the next morning you're inspired, you have intention, you're manifesting your healing, etc. That's how you can work with these planets, this retrograde cycle, in a way that is constructive and positive to your own healing. And that's really exciting. All right, you guys, so that's what it is that I'm seeing for us this week. Please know that this community is non-judgmental. My YouTube channel is something that is, I've already set intention, is protected and valuable to me. So if you need any support or if you have any questions, let me know down in the comments. I'm more than happy to answer those for you. In the meantime, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button, because that really does a world of a difference when it comes to where my YouTube channel goes and the growth of the YouTube channel outside of my intentions, but also we're a community and we love to help each other out. Until then, you guys, make sure that you are subscribed to this YouTube channel, because there's plenty more videos where this came from, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!